Okay, that's the frame brought inside, and it does not look too shabby at all. The first thing that strikes me about this one is the fact that it is noticeably lighter, even just from picking it up, so that's a good thing. It may be a bad thing depending how it flies. So next thing I'm going to do is the mounting of the four motors. First of all, you should have printed out your set. You have a look, a set of the motor mounts. This was a prototype one I did initially. It's great rigidity on it, but it was 4mm thick, both of them, which is kind of overkill, and it took quite a while to print those out, and it was unnecessary to have them that thick. And also I was using two spacers on these, but it seems pointless, so I'm just going to use the one spacer and see how that goes. If it's strong enough, then good. If not, I'll have to go back and redesign those to make it a two spacer setup. The spacers I'm talking about are these little hexagonal spacers. I think you can get them from computer boards, if you can get hold of old computer boards or something along those lines. This one is a 10mm for obvious reasons. To go with my 10mm aluminium framing. And also I'm using, obviously I think I've said this before, everything is going to be an M3 size nut or bolt, just to keep it all uniform, and it's strong enough, M3, easy strong enough. So on these Hextronics, first of all you have to detach the bases and mount the base, first of all, onto the bottom piece, and then install the rest of the top mount, and then install it onto the frame. You can leave the motor off till the very last, well you can actually install those when it's on the frame itself, so just put the motor to one side, forget about that. Now these, I've done the spacing, it's unfortunately three holes required on these motor mounts, which seems, again, sort of excessive, and you're using up all your nuts and bolts on this thing and adding the weight, I guess, but it just seems a lot of overkill on the putting together of this thing. Never mind, we'll do it. These are quite tight. They may feel tight on the PLA mount, but if you just get screwing them in, it will purchase through easy enough. And they're all lined up pretty good. I'll just put them all through first of all, and then do the nut later on. These are a little bit long, I mean, you can get away with, what's that, 3, 4, I'm not sure what length these are. They're about 6-7mm. I'd have to check those, but they are sort of overkill. Saying that, depends what you're going to put on the bottom of them. I'll show you in a moment what I'm using on mine, which isn't the norm. Again, screw all those in. See the stick through, probably too much. Now what I've been using are these little, like a little grabbing washer. They are threaded, but it has got like serrated teeth on it, so it will bite into the PLA. Now the motor mount, I haven't really designed anything into this motor mount at the moment. It's really kind of caveman design. But I'll go back and sort that out. However, I am still using these little screw cap things, just to get the clearance, really. Oh, they are fiddly. And you can sort of see the idea. Eventually I will have those embedded within the PLA, and a shorter bolt through there, and that should hide it a lot better. again, because it's early days, I'm not sure what lengths work and what don't, and I have to sort of use what I've got lying around at the moment. So it's a case of putting all those on. You can just use a normal M3 nylock nut on there. It'd probably work better with this length of screw anyway. Problem with these sticking through as well, the motor mounts the lowest point on the h-copter, so in effect these things are going to drag a little bit on the floor, so I have to sort that out by the time I put this thing in the air. I'll just do this one and then you get the idea. It's pretty much repeated. Just nip them up a little bit. I mean, they don't have to be that tight. It's not as though they're carrying a lot of load on them. That's three. There we go. One more to mount. You see, they do stick through too much. I mean, that's obviously going to be a kind of a grabbing hazard. But for the time being, it doesn't matter. Again, it's sort of to learn from building these to see which one is the best way to go. The huge 12mm, which I have to say is not too bad at all. I'm looking forward to putting that one through its paces properly. But if this one's lighter and it flies the same way as the 12mm version does, then I'll be happy. I'll be very happy. Right, so the next thing for these motor mounts is going to be the spacer bar. Again, the holes are tight, but they do work pretty good, I have to say. So, screwing the spacer. Again, just nip that up. That's how it's going to look. And then, finally, the top piece. Again, these are only about, they must be about 5mm long, these M3 bolts. They work perfect. I would have used these for the actual motor mount as well, but I don't have enough of them, I don't think, especially with the two of them being built. So there we go, that's one. Doesn't feel that rigid there, however. Once we get it on there in position, oh, that's plenty solid enough, that might be fine. So I'll go try and find some, what you're looking at, a 10, 15, about a 20mm bolt for there. I'll go and see if I dig some of those out. A good fitting screw, or bolt I should say. I think that's about 20mm long. Can't really measure it. Again, it's up to everyone to find out what works for them, but just as a guide. So if I can measure that, I'll give a rough estimate of what it's going to be. At least people can sort of order. Oops. Yeah, it's 20mm. And then 320mm. And that works pretty good. These holes have turned out pretty good as well with the Ultimaker, I have to say. It's a good size tolerance. It's the first time I think I've got it right, first time for one of the Ultimaker holes. Okay. Again, I'm just using a lock nut on there. Those are not right for a start, those are M4. Got one. trying to do this without obscuring the camera. It's kind of left-handed for me. Got that is one pretty rigid motor mount. I'll put the motor on as well as a just as a reference guide. You have to watch these Hextronics, you have to make sure you don't push them too far in, otherwise they do catch on something. I thought I had two broken motors once when I was trying the first one, and it turned out I just put them in too tight. Alright, it's one free spinning motor. I'll go on and put the other three on. There's a little bit of movement in there, I have to say. I don't know how that will affect. I mean, you have to really pull on it to make it move, but it does move. But that'd have been better if I printed it out at 100% infill, which I have done with some that are going on in the background, printing at 100% as a comparison. So we'll find out which one works best and which one. I mean, I'd like to use this, you know, these that didn't take long to print at all, but I can feel a bit of flex in them, even compared to the these 4mm ones. I mean, that may be the way to go. Do this, do the bottom one as a 4mm. Still work in progress, anyway. The reason for the front, while I've got it here and I've got my camera handy, this is totally suited towards the GoPro. That's what the front's for, rather than have a flat like loading bay, if you like, at the front. I've gone with this proper GoPro interface, which you just snap it on. There you go, one GoPro. And I think that'll work quite well. And somewhere I'm going to stick a FPV camera on there, underneath maybe. I don't know. That's the. I mean, it took a bit of cleaning. I've already sandpapered this. I mean, it, when I say a bit of cleaning, it took less than 5 minutes to do. Took a Sharpie to it and a bit of sandpaper, and that worked perfect. Yeah, then what else was that? I'm sure there was something else. Oh, the bottom. Already I can feel it, even just moving it on the carpet, I can feel these the ends of these bolts hooking up on the carpet, so it's going to need some landing, kind of, just to get it another 10 mm or so off the ground. I need some kind of landing feet or plate or something on there. It shouldn't be too hard to do. I mean, if you're taking off with from grass, it shouldn't really matter anyway. So here we go, and I'll crack on and get the other four motors on. Okay, here we are. All four motors are in place. One thing I did notice, depressingly, and it's not a good thing, it is the twist within the frame, the dreaded twist on this thing. It is very, very noticeable on it. I mean, I can, looking about a 30mm deflection there from one side to the other. I've looked at these corners, and yeah, that one especially is not a very good joint there. So that's not helping with things. I just think if I can, I even saw I can feel that when I twist it, I can feel that corner moving. That's why it's very important to get the edges square in there. I thought this blocking in here would keep it sort of fixed more. But on this version, I actually opened the gap up a little bit more to get the rod in easier. Before, I really had to push it in quite hard, and it twisted the PLA a little bit. But this time, I opened the gap up, and it sort of made it worse, really, as regards the twisting on it. So, in this current state, it's not going to be very good. What I'm thinking of doing is fabricating again something with the Ultimaker, and just to fill in sort of mirror of this upstand piece, if you like, and fill this whole end in, same with the other end, and just glue it all, get as much glue in there as possible. So it's more or less going to be a mirror. Oh, I can actually see there's a gap. You see, that's not good. I wonder if I could push that in. Yeah, that's not helping at all. I can see the bar twisting. So I'm not sure what I'm going to do with that. That's not good at all. I'm not sure whether this is a case of scrapping this PLA frame and stewing it again. It's definitely not good. It's very important to get these two aluminium verticals the same length, so that it will be square and butt up nicely against it. So I'm going to have a think about it, and I'm not sure, maybe try, like I say, try a few things as regards blocking this whole end up with PLA and gluing it so it's got nowhere to move. That should work. I mean, it'd be like putting a piece of board across there. It would stop it turning over. Yeah, that's going to be my fix anyway. So I'm going to hold on any more construction until I've sorted that twisting motion out. That's a shame, that. That would have been nice. So maybe the 12mm is the way to go. It's just creating more questions for me, really. Whether the 12mm version was the way to go, or whether the 10mm version would have worked if I'd got that corner sorted out a lot better than I have. This end's not... it's not so bad. I can still see it moving in the frame, so I'm going to tighten up the PLA gap there. I think that's also half the trouble, so I'll just take a little bit of that tolerance away, and hopefully that'll hold it a lot better. So I'm just having to develop these files as I go along. So hopefully the files that are loaded onto Thingiverse, by the time you come to download them, they'll be a lot better than the ones I've been working to, or at least modified and enhanced. Let's see the twist. I'll move it. Oh, that moves far too much. So that's where we are. Motor mounts don't, they don't look too bad, and those, there's a bit of movement in those as well. I don't know how much that'll affect it. I don't think that'll matter too much, because you really have to work them to make them bend. So there we go. H-copter, the torsion is way too much, so I've been thinking about it, and rather than take it all apart, I thought I'd do a remedial fix, if you like. I'd like to just get it built, get it in the air, and then take it from there. I think what I should have done is... these upstands here, which actually hold the SHS in place, I don't think they're high enough. They're about 6mm. I mean, the bar itself is obviously 10. I should have come up, I probably should have come up all the way. With it being such a smaller gauge bar, I think that's causing a lot of the problems. So I think on the new STL files, I will take these upstands and I'll run them the full 10mm all round, excluding the centrepiece ones. Hopefully that will prevent the torsion a little bit. I can actually see as well the gap that I've increased in there to allow the bar to slide in earlier, easier. That hasn't helped because I can actually see there is a visible gap there. So I've reduced that size on the STL files as well, so it'll be a push tight fit like it was on the 12mm version. So anyway, as I was saying, I don't want to take this one apart. I was going to take it apart and maybe trim the ends up, try and square them off. What I could do with is a chop saw, and that could have lined those up and got a much better cut on them. You can see I was a little bit beer-eyed, I think, when I cut those. I just cut them with a hacksaw and eyed it kind of style. And you can see, I think I've already, I did them both at the same time, I think, cutting them. But when I've come to put them in, I've orientated them in different directions, if that makes sense. So the skew on the ends are slightly different, so they're not matching up with each other. However, my fix for this is going to be, Ultimaker style of course, a capping plate. Now this is sort of a negative, let's see, orientate it properly, this is going to be a negative of this whole area here, and I'm just going to glue it. I have to cut these little bits down, which will look my fancy locating places. They were like the centre points, and now I'm going to have to grind them down or something. Just, I think I'll be able to get a Sharpie on those and cut them off. So this, I've just printed 100% to make sure it's going to be sturdy enough, and that is just literally going to snap on. I've done a test fit, and that is going to snap on like that, and I'm hoping, get a bit of pressure on that, and I'm hoping that, even if I hold it, you can see it removes a lot of the torsion at that end. So that is pretty good. I think it's a pretty good temporary fix anyway. So I'm going to glue that up and get some weight on it overnight. It'll mess up the top of it and the centre and the wiring and pretty much everything else on that upper deck, but I'd rather get it sorted out and in the air, and then work backwards and figure out what else I can do to make it a much better and easier connection at that end. I'm pretty sure that'll work. I'm more than happy with the way that's turned out. It's a little bit excessive as regards the size of it, but again, I wanted to make sure it works rather than wondering whether it will work or not. So yeah, that should do it. Just a slight gap on there. And again, I'm printing another one off the same thing at that end. It's pretty much a mirror image, to be honest. So hopefully that will get away with removing all the torsion upon it. Yeah, I think I also made those inner ones, looking at it now, I made the inner one actually even lower. I was trying to save on printing time in PLA, and they're probably only halfway up the 10mm bar, so about 5mm high, if that. So that's my fix. I'm going to glue it up and let's see if it works or not. Alright, that's 20 minutes up approximately. So I'm just going to somehow get that on there. I'm just going to leave it here for the time being. I'm waiting for the second one to fully print out, and I'll do the same with that one, and then I will take it outside to the garage and apply as much weight as I possibly can. And